Dear friends, we are coming to you from the land of Israel today, and the series is Israel Essential. Here we are to talk about the land of Israel, the people, their culture, and why they rule the world in technology. And today we have the founder of OurCrowd, one of the leading venture capitalist firms, John Medved. Thank you so much for being with us.
It's great to be here with you, Dr. Paul. Thank you.
Thank you, John. Israel is known for startups, and literally the startups rule the world in technology. Can you tell us why it's so? And also, we'd like to hear from you about what are the startups which have ruled the world and helped people and built the lives of people?
So, first of all, in the Jewish tradition, we have a long history of being partners with God in creation. According to our understanding of the Torah and the way that the world was made, God created the world in 6 days and then mm-hmm. rested. But it wasn't complete. We don't believe that the work is done. It's left to man to perfect the world. According to Jewish tradition, we believe in something called tikkun olam, which is fixing the universe. Mm-hmm. So if you look back in Jewish history, Jews have always been active, not just in bringing morality and law and, you know, great wisdom to the world, but also in technology. Our forefathers, if you look at Jacob, for example, and he was with Laban, he actually engaged in a form of genetic engineering with mm-hmm. the goats and the sheep and his flocks. If you look at Isaac, mm-hmm. he was a great hydrologist. He built wells, okay, in the desert. Abraham was a very serious businessman. And so in the Jewish tradition, we've always believed that you have to create, you have to build, that business is actually a godly act. Mm-hmm. That business is not something evil. Mm-hmm. Business is to provide work for other people as well as yourself, to provide for your family. And today with technology, you're able to actually build businesses mm-hmm. that will solve global challenges. Mm-hmm. These global challenges can be in areas of hunger. So for example, in India, 65% of the population is still engaged in agriculture. Mm-hmm. And much of that agriculture is still being done the way it was done for literally thousands of years. Today, with the cell phone, with big data, mm-hmm. with the Internet of Things sensors, we can enable the simple farmer to double, triple, quadruple, even build by a factor of 10, his productivity and his output. By doing so, he'll provide more food for the hungry, mm-hmm. but also more food for his own family, more dignity, more ability to move forward so he can educate his children, and that we can move this in a very positive way. In Israel, we have technologies about water usage. We're probably the world leader in water technology, both desalination, drip irrigation, recycling of water. We lead in terms of big data for farming. We lead in terms of digital health, how you can turn these cell phones into not just tools of communication, mm-hmm. but tools of healing. Mm-hmm. How do you heal people by using data to better understand what needs to be done to make people healthy? We can help people get educated. There's tremendous activity. Much of this is surrounding what we call artificial intelligence or machine learning, mm-hmm. using the power of computers in our God-given right to actually reach for the stars and to give people tremendous ability to change their environment. So here in Israel, this is the national business.
Mm-hmm. So Israel has developed this. Has it actually worked with countries to bring these essential areas where life can be developed in different countries?
Well, absolutely. Again, I'll come back to India as a good example. There are a number of Israeli demonstration centers all over India, where they're bringing farmers to teach them, where they're bringing educators to teach them. We are doing the best we can to spread this technology out. We are investing in Indian companies. Mm-hmm. So for example, at our crowd, we've invested in a fine Indian company called Zoomcar, mm-hmm. which is changing the way that car rentals are done in India. Many of our companies are working with Indian partners. We have a company called Zebra Medical, who use artificial intelligence to interpret radiological images. So what your doctor used to do by looking up at a light board where he would see the x-ray, mm-hmm. now a computer can do this and do it in an automated fashion. So Zebra just signed a major deal with the Apollo hospital chain, which is India's largest chain of privately owned hospitals. And we have another company called Site Diagnostics, who are building a market-leading blood testing kit that in its first incarnation, what it does is it tests for malaria very effectively, very cheaply, and it's obviously of great need for India. So there's a variety of these companies and projects that are already impacting not just India, but in Latin America, in Southeast Asia, all over Africa. And Israel is tackling these problems with a lot of energy and creativity. Mm-hmm.
I can endorse that with our university, Karunya University in India, working with Technion, Ben Gurion University, and Hebrew University in terms of agriculture. And the revolutionary ways in which food production has developed in Israel has been shared with India also. So it's a great way forward, and developing the young students to think out of the box and bring in new technologies and so on. So it's a great service that Israel is doing to the world. They say the next war is going to be only about food and water across the world. And this is bringing solutions to the needs of the world. Thank you so much, John, for sharing your heart and bringing hope to the world.
Thank you, Dr.
Thank you. Paul.